Hi y'all, it's me, Mickey, in Mickey's Kitchen. About to do a really quick, short recipe with you guys. It's called Hobo Packets, which I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with. Let me go over the ingredients first. So first we've got 3 pounds of ground chuck, because I'm making like 6 big packets with 6 big patties. But I use the beefy onion recipe in mine, and I use 2 envelopes per 3 pounds. Each envelope, I think is, no, 2.2 ounces is the whole box. Well, anyway, it's 2 of these. 2 packets, the Lipton's beefy onion, to 3 pounds of ground chuck. See if I can move this camera down a little bit. So I mix my 3 pounds of chuck with the onion soup, and I also put a little bit of black pepper. You can eyeball the black pepper to what suits you, to what you prefer. And here's my other ingredients. I don't know if it would be easier to take the camera or just to show you. But this would be my first time putting Brussels sprouts in these packets. I love Brussels sprouts, so we're gonna try Brussels sprouts in these today. But what I typically do is sliced fresh carrot, sliced sweet onion, which this is 2 onions, and that's a whole pack of regular carrots. And then we've got about 6 medium potatoes cut thin. Well, some are pretty thick, some are a little bit thinner, but you can eyeball it. But the thickness of your vegetables is going to depend on how long you actually cook everything. So I'm going to give you an eyeball time for this. I would say cook it on 400 for about 45 to 50 minutes. I say at 40, 45 minutes, check it and see how tender your vegetables are. But I would say around that time it should get done. It may take longer depending on the contents of what's in your packet. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start by layering. Let me get me some pan cooking spray. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take some pan cooking spray, and we're gonna take these sheets of foil. These are 6 sheets because I got 6 patties. I'm just going to lightly spray that. Maybe I should scoop the meat back and do it this way so y'all can see better. Here we go. Oh, I don't know if I mentioned Campbell's cream of mushroom. This is a family size can. It is 1 pound, 6.6 ounces. And that should be plenty for 6 patties, but everything is your preference and what you like. So we're gonna start with some potatoes. Like I said, you can put as little or as much as you want of these. I think we got about 6 potatoes there. Maybe we'll do about 8. Like I said, we're really just eyeballing all this stuff. It's just whatever you wanna do. I like a lot of veggies. So the next thing we're gonna do, let's put a little olive oil on top of these potatoes. Really, you can just drizzle olive oil on the top of all of them once you get your vegetables stacked up. But I just like to put a little bit. And also, we'll go ahead and pepper these a little bit. This is fresh ground pepper, black pepper. And this is sea salt. Put a little bit of that. And keep in mind when salting it that the hamburger is already extremely salted from the Lipton soup, and then you've also got the sodium in your cream of mushroom. So take it easy on the salt with the veggies because you don't want to overdo it. So then we're going to take these thin slices of onion. Like I said, it's your preference to how much you want to put in each packet, but I want us to get full, so I'm not going to be light with it. So that's the onions. Next, we're gonna do the carrots. And I like to layer things in a way that I think would take more time to cook. Like I think the potatoes, especially since it's a big bulk amount of them, will take a little bit more time to cook than the other stuff. So I always like to like start with those on the bottom. Sometimes I put the carrots next and put the onions on top. And now these Brussels sprouts I've never done before, but Brussels sprouts cook fairly quick. Some of these, as you can see, I have halved. Some of the ones that are a little bigger, and then some of these aren't real big, I just left whole because I don't think it's gonna take them a lot of time. And I love Brussels sprouts, so I'm gonna be a little heavy-handed on those. Like I said, I got 6 packets and I got plenty of Brussels sprouts. So I'm gonna put just a little bit more olive oil, because you know there'll be fat coming after chuck. You don't need a ton of oil unless you was to use a real lean meat. I'm gonna put a little bit more pepper on that. Then we're gonna take our hamburger. I wanna try to not get my hands dirty and have to like go wash my hands. So we're gonna just use these tongs today. But I'm gonna take my hamburger patty. I'm gonna lay it right on top. And then you're gonna take a healthy dollop of creamy mushroom. In my case, I'm gonna take 2 healthy spoonfuls because to me, that's what really makes it. But literally, that's it. This is the hobo packet. Isn't that pretty? I don't know how good y'all can see that. I probably shouldn't even attempt this. Let's do it this way. I want y'all to get a better view of that. But that's the hobo patty. And we're gonna bake it for 45 to 50 minutes, depending on how heavy of a packet you make and how thickly you cut your vegetables really determine the time. And we're gonna bake these on 400 for about 45 to 50 minutes. And you just wanna seal these real good, like an envelope, turn them up. So if any juice bubbles out, hopefully it'll stay in. Ooh, this is a bit moist. The vegetables are trying to come out the side. So we're gonna do that. And I'm just gonna put them on a cookie sheet. Let me push that up a little bit. I don't know if you can see that, but I've got 2 cookie sheets here because I didn't know if I was gonna need 2 or 1, but these are humongous cookie sheets. So I'm gonna take this cookie sheet here and just put this first hobo packet on. And I'm just gonna continue to build as we go. That's hobo packets, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And once again, we have thin potatoes, Brussels sprouts, carrots, sweet onion, olive oil, Campbell's cream mushroom, beefy Lipton soup is in the 3 pounds of beef. I use 2 packets, and I probably use about a teaspoon and a half of ground pepper, but you eyeball it or don't even add the pepper if you don't want to. Like I said, just be really careful with adding extra salt on your veggies after you put the oil and you salt and pepper them, because there's a lot of sodium in the soup, the dry soup, and the Campbell's soup. So anyway, that's it. That's my beefy hobo dinner. I'm gonna go ahead and build these other 5 and get these in the oven. The hobo packets are out of the oven. I'm gonna check them for doneness. I went ahead and put 1 on this plate because they are piping hot. The heat really rolls out of those things where they're closed up. So we're gonna carefully open this and let some of this heat roll out. So I put it on a plate because you can see the juice running down the foil. Ooh, that looks pretty mean. Yes, 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 that looks good. Let's see if I can show y'all better. It looks done, but I'm gonna taste it for doneness just to be sure. Also, I like to add a little fresh parsley on top. You don't have to do that if you don't want to. But I like things to look a certain way. Even though I must admit this isn't the prettiest picture from that view. So the hamburger is definitely done. This is a whole Brussels sprout and my fork went right through that. I believe that those Brussels sprouts are done. The potatoes probably are done too. So I'm gonna let this cool so I don't burn my mouth up. Let's see what we got going on here. Ooh, that's piping hot. Well, while that's cooling, I'm just gonna get another fork. I'll just go ahead and check the tenderness of the potatoes and the onions. Yeah, the onions are definitely done. And the potatoes are too. Very tender, breaking right on apart. Everything's done. Carrots, done, not overly cooked, but tender. I think we hit that one right on the head. I ended up cooking these for 45 minutes, and I actually set a timer and took them out at 45 minutes. And this is a pretty hefty packet. It's a lot of veggies, big old hamburger patties, tons of everything, and it got done. And also, even though I had various packets, I ended up just putting four in. I baked four at a time, and now I'm baking the other ones because I didn't want it to take too long. I'm telling you, this is still smoking. Y'all can't see me, can you? There we go. And that cream of mushroom just is so luscious on there. Ooh, hot. Good, good. Ooh. Maybe I'll need to do it right at the oven sample next time. It's really good though. I think the Brussels sprout could use more salt for my liking. But like I said, take it easy because it's salt in the meat from the mushroom pack. It's salt in the cream of mushroom. There's a lot of sodium, so I would definitely, you know, salt it a little bit, but then go back and see what you think it needs. It's good. Very good. I'm gonna use more salt. So I'll be talking with my mouth open. But I want y'all to see the finished product. And there's a lot of juice in there from that ground chuck. You know, chuck is pretty fatty. But this is delicious. A simple little packet meal. Not the prettiest thing, but it is delicious. Thank y'all for tuning in. Hope you all try this hobo meal. Talk to you guys later. Bye.